These are the best Google Keep Tips Desktop Edition. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews, but mainly it's all Google all the time around here. And today is no different. So these are the best Google Keep Tips Desktop Edition. Let's go. So first things first, if you're new to Google Keep and want to know how to use Google Keep or even how to access Google Keep, you're going to want to check out the links in the description below, or you can click right up here. Once you do that, then come back here and watch this video. It'll make a lot more sense then, I promise. With that said, tip number one is to add an image to Google Keep. I love this one. So there are a couple of ways to add images to Google Keep. First, if you're already in a note, click on the image icon near the bottom of the note. Simply select the image you'd like to add. And now you have that image in the note. And by the way, to delete an image, just hover over it and then click on that trash can icon that appears in the bottom right. And if you're not in an existing note, you can still add an image. This time up in the Take a Note box at the top, click on the image icon to the very right, select an image from your computer, and then your image will be added to a new note. And by the way, you can add multiple images to a Keep note as well. Google Keep tip number two is to collaborate in notes. This is so helpful if you work with a team or even want to share a note with your family members. So there are multiple ways to do this too. So from your main notes dashboard, you can hover your mouse over the note and click the collaborator icon. Then in this pop-up here, you can add the person or email that you want to share the note with. Or if you're currently in a note already, let's say you're taking meeting notes and you're ready to add some collaborators, you can just click on that collaborator icon near the bottom left of the note. And those that you want to share the note with, you can just add them here and then click save. You can add as many people as you want, and they don't even have to have a Gmail account. So they're still going to get an email notification asking them to collaborate on a note. And then you're even going to have icons here indicating that these notes are shared and who they're shared with. And of course, you can have different people collaborating on different notes. Keep tip number three, convert notes to checklists. This is a time saver when it comes to note taking. So let's say you've written a note really quickly and you realize that maybe you rather have this note as a checklist so that you can check off items off your to-do list. All you have to do is click on the three-dot menu icon near the bottom and select show checkboxes. And your note has converted automatically into a list for you. Then you can just check items off your list one at a time. Easy as that. Number four on my list of best Google Keep tips is to set a reminder. This is so helpful if you are forgetful like I am. From a note in Google Keep, you're gonna have a little bell icon in the bottom left. If you click on that, you'll have a ton of reminder options to choose from. And in fact, if you have home and work addresses set up in Google Maps, it's gonna pull those automatically for you here. But the important thing here is that you can pick a date and time that you wanna be reminded at, and then you can even select this as repeating or not. So then you'll just tap on save to save the date and time reminder. And what's great is this reminder is automatically added over to your Google Calendar. But you can also set a reminder based on location. And to be clear, you can set a reminder for date and time or location. You can't do both at the same time. So once again, from that bell icon, you'd select pick a place, and then you'd add in the address of the place. So in order for this to work, you're going to need to allow permission, because once a location reminder is set, you're gonna get a notification when you get to that spot. So think about how helpful this would be for like your shopping list, and then you get that notification when you arrive to the grocery store. And before we pop into tip number five, if you're liking this video so far, go ahead and give this video a like, and remember to subscribe to my channel for more content just like this. Why wouldn't you? And moving on to tip number five, color code your notes. If you guys have watched any of my other videos, you know I am very big on color blocking, and it really helps to give me a visual cue in terms of my organization. Well, you may have noticed some of my notes in Google Keep are different colors. So all you have to do is click on the little paint palette icon. This is the background colors option. And then from here, you can pick a color, or you could even pick a theme if you wanted. And remember, most of these little tips, you don't have to be in a note to always access these features. You can just hover over a note from your main notes dashboard here and get those same icons along the bottom. And Google Keep tip number 6 is to add a label. This is another essential organization tip you're going to want to take advantage of. So click the 3-dot menu icon near the bottom of a note. And the second option here is the option to add a label. This is key for organizing your notes. Think if you had thousands of notes all floating around in here and some belong to different projects or clients, you'd have to manually search for anything and everything. But if you add labels, you can quickly find anything you're looking for. So click Add Label, and then here you can either create a new label or you can add it to a label that you've already created. So now on the left-hand side of your notes dashboard, you can quickly drill down to the specific notes you want per label. Plus all of these things, by the way, like locations and collaborators and labels that we're adding, will be viewable at a quick glance of your notes. So it's like adding custom tags to every note. Like this one is tied to an address and it's shared. This one is labeled for YouTube, things like that. And you can edit your labels at any time, by the way, by clicking on the Edit Labels option on the left. This brings us to tip number 7, which is to archive notes. Now, this is not the same thing as deleting a note, by the way, but it's a great way to clean up your main note dashboard. So all you have to do is click on the archive icon near the bottom of a note. And archiving is great for when you're all done with that note or task list, because it's going to remove the note from the main dashboard section here. But if you select the archive option on the left-hand panel, you're going to have all your archived notes there. And don't worry if you archive something by mistake or if you have to reopen a note or project. If you hover over that note in the archive section, you now have the option to unarchive it and move it back to your notes section. Now you can of course fully delete a note by clicking the 3-dot menu icon in the note and then selecting delete note. This is gonna move that note to the trash bin, which you're gonna be able to access here on the left as well. You can either manually empty out your trash bin, but notes, just so you know, are automatically removed from your trash bin after 7 days. And while we're on the topic of cleaning up our main notes dashboard, tip number 8 is to pin a note. This is really helpful if you're working on something really important and you want to keep it top of mind, or top of keep, as it were. So to pin a note, all you have to do is hover over it on the main page here and click on the little pin icon in the top right. Now that icon is in the same spot from an opened note too, by the way. Once you pin a note, it's going to be pinned at the top of your notes dashboard in a pinned notes section. And you can unpin a note at any time by clicking on that same pin icon. And before I move on to the last, but certainly not least, Google Keep tip, it's important to note, get it, that you can access Google Keep across devices. So any changes or notes you make to desktop, they will be available on mobile and vice versa. And by the way, if you want a full list of Google Keep for mobile tips, I've got that linked in the description as well. But on to our last tip of the day, and that's to rearrange your notes quickly and easily. I use this a lot for my visual organization as well. Literally all you have to do is click and drag and drop a note to where you want it. So you may not want to necessarily pin a particular note to the top, but maybe you want this note ahead of another note. So you can just drag it and drop it into place. It's really that easy. Remember, if you still have any questions on Google Keep or want specific mobile app tips, you're gonna wanna check out those links in the description below. Until then, keep on keeping on. I'm sorry, I won't do that again. So those are my picks for the best Google Keep tips, desktop edition. And now I want to hear from you. What are your favorite Google Keep tips and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here and here for even more Google Keep tips. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Hold for construction. Construction noise.